Here we go, recording. Hey, what's up, YouTubers, the YouTube world? This is your boy, that boy. You know who it is, that MJS Techniques. I got my dungeon guide going right now. All right, so last time I was in here, you know I like to go solo. But today, I wanted to come in with my buddies. You know, I've already done this before with two of my company members before. Unfortunately, I was only able to get one. Mr. TS with the crown over here. The snake. And he's going to come and we're just going to wreck the hell out of this. And just to add an additional bonus, not only is my brother from another mother here, but he's going to narrate these awesome encounters because I just want to sit back and watch him dance around with that great sword of his. So
yeah, let the person that ain't done this dungeon in about 6 months narrate. That works.
Exactly, man. I wouldn't have it on the way. I don't trust anybody more than you. Oh, if you can let me know, bro, though, when you have like a debuff on you, so I can assume it. Cause I told you all my icons are small. Cause I was letting them know that I got these new couches. And
no, bro.
I'm sitting real, like I'm lean and hard body, man. So I can't read anything. But you know, I know how to stare at bars. But ever since I was young, you know, they would be like, "You're not made of glass," because I would be just sitting in front of the boob tube, you know, as close as I could be. So I try to typically play pretty close, so I can see everything that's going on. But I just can't resist these couches. Now Jason and I have been, you know, we go back a little bit, we go prior to the 14 over here that you guys always see me banging buttons on my bongo drums. And I had told him about this one, and he loved Final Fantasy, so I was happy that it ended up working out so well. He is an amazing player, you know, and I don't really honestly trust anybody out in the arena more than this man right here.
I just needed something else to focus my time on. I couldn't do any more of those, man. Too many MMOs in my life. Too many years of my life wasted behind one.
Yeah, man, you know I know a little bit about that, but if you wouldn't mind, you know, sharing maybe one of the games that you played. I told him I had a little before you go into it. I'm sorry to cut you off right as I was about to start you.
How the hell?
But
get your ass over here.
I had told them that I had a little experience in 11. I had started when I did Dust Vigil. I explained to them that I played a Taru Taru Black Mage because they were adorable little, you know, like mole people.
The little black nosed bastards. I mean, 11 was cool, but they're towards the later parts of the game, it just started to get boring, especially with some of the time that you would spend doing the boss battles. It's kind of pointless to spend 4 or 5 hours on a boss. It's just not worth my time. I mean, I've done everything from Star Wars, both, you know, Galaxy and Knights of the Old Republic, to Rift, Aeon, Dark Age of Camelot. I mean, there's very few MMOs that have come out that I have not played or at least maxed a character out on.
Yeah, that's awesome. Which one would you say was one of your favorites? And if you could just maybe explain
to
like one of the jobs you played or one of the roles.
We'll see. What I consider my favorite MMO by today's standards, people wouldn't touch because there's too many people who want instant gratification. My very first MMO was a game called Azran's Call, and I started playing it in 97, and it was the true definition of farm camp. There was no actual quest line. It was go out and kill, do what you want to do when you want to do it. PvP, what people consider PvP today is a joke. compared to the PvP that I'm used to playing. PvP in Asheron's Call, if you killed somebody, you could take their loot. That means any gear that they might have on their person. Hell, it could be gear that they're actually using, because when you die, you drop your most expensive items on your corpse, and you would have to go retrieve your corpse. Well, if in PvP somebody kills you, they earn the right to open your corpse and take anything you want. So for all these little pansies out there that go, "Oh, I'm so badass,"
bro,
there was a way to prove it back in the day.
You're supposed to explain the fights, man. Oh, man.
Don't stand in bad. There's nothing to explain to this fight.
While
if you stand in shit, you're going to die. That's
well, look, everybody. If you notice, we all turned into... two of us turned into frogs, you know.
Two people will turn into frogs. Stay away from the bubbles with the notes. They will cast an AOE. When you need to Asuna. Whenever I get concussion, you need to Asuna as a white
oh,
mage.
Oh, it's right now. Okay,
that
I see it.
Asuna, yes.
Yeah. I thought you were explaining,
I didn't notice that you had it,
because you know of my current predicament.
DPS, kill adds, and that's it. That's the whole fight. Kill adds, stay away from the notes. When your tank gets concussion, Asuna. That's it. Keep the boss faced away from the party. So when he casts Croak, it doesn't just sit there and AoE pound on him, and that's about it.
Sweet. Yeah,
now
man, you know,
I forget
about these too,
the
man. But look, check me out, guys. I'm like this little frog, and I jump around. And what you want to do is you want to go in the same direction as the other frog so that you guys
actually,
don't hit each other.
Actually, it's better to do circles.
Circles?
It's better
okay.
to do large. Yeah, just go to one side and do a large circle. All
right,
that
guys.
That keeps everybody out of your way, and you take no chance of DPS crossing your path.
You took it
Asuna?
From the best. He said that you do not want to run in the same direction, but you want to run in big circles. Word, we got it. Oh, wait, you have something on you. I gotta come take it off you, man.
I have nothing on me, bro.
What? Oh, I guess you were flying. Alright, let's go. Let's do this.
These pulls are just basic, depending on your gear. If you've got a decent gear, you can pull to each stop.
Nice. Yeah, man, because some groups, they don't go this far in with the groups.
What the hell is with the homunculus up there just hanging around?
Stupid homunculus. I'm gonna kick your butts.
They've been kind of sketchy since they brought this dungeon out. I don't know why they have that lag when they come out the door.
Yeah, so I recently... Because I just told you, Jay, that I just started doing... the recordings. I put up three. One's a blooper. But it's a partial. It's the majority of the dungeon. And it came out pretty good. So it still works. So that's up. And then I have two other complete ones. But I have maybe two or three more recorded. That I haven't put up.
And if they're doing their DPS right, the massive should be the first, and then the erodings, and then the homunculus.
Alright, so that big giant thing we should kill first, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, so yes. As you can see, they're not really focus targeting properly, but typically they, you know, everyone that watches, they're accustomed to me kind of coming in here with pugs. I told you the two times I came in with a couple mates, but it was still a majority, you know, when we went in there with the other person, we would just pick up another random. But it was just that one time. I would like to get more of the company members involved. DJ really wants to be in a video. He's like, oh, you gotta give me some more time. I'm like, yeah, man. I'm gonna let him know that we shout him out. We're shouting out right now DJ Goku from Zalera Server, company Master. He'll be in some movies, hopefully. A whole bunch of them.
Yeah, once he gets his shit straight.
He was on. He's been on the past couple of nights. I mean.
Nah. So he finally, sounds like he finally got his shit taken care of now.
Yeah, he's back. He's just doing.
I know
doing...
he was taking a break. He had some family real life stuff he had to take care of.
Yeah.
Kill ads.
Yeah, and I typically
kill
do
ads.
My stuff. I'm sorry, go for it.
Kill Stardust. Kill ads, kill Stardust. Don't stand in bad. If you get a line from Ziggy to you, put the Stardust boulder between you and him. That's it.
All right, guys, and from bad, what he means is, what you know when I always show them, the obvious special attacks that the boss does, the ones that you are typically red, like that one. That's bad. So if ever here don't stand in bad, it means the usual, oh, you're right, I wouldn't want to be in that. Because we use the bad.
Oh, and just a little helpful hint for you, Matt. At this point in time, if you want to clear Stardust quickly, throw on your cleric stance, stand in the middle of the room, and do an assize. It'll pretty much wipe them all out at once.
Which is assize?
That's the one that does the AoE damage, healing, and mana regen.
Oh, man.
Get behind the block.
I, like,
and
never
Dragoon,
used that one.
And that is what you don't do. Dragoon just failed. He's fixing to get hit for a second time because he's not hiding.
Yeah, everyone, in this one, when you're tethered to the boss, you want to hide behind one of these boulders here. I was not staring at the Dragoons, so I didn't notice that he...
Adds up. Matt, please come to me. That'll bring the other ad to me. Okay. Hopefully they're... Well... They're not killing Stardust fast enough. This is going to hurt.
Oh, I'm gonna have to heal. Damn it, man. Sorry, man. I couldn't find the button, and I'm not sure where it's located right now.
When you get the target, go to the rock. It's not that hard. Stand there and wait. Go to the next rock. Stand there and wait. Go to the next rock. Stand there and wait.
As you can see, Jason's over here standing behind different boulders.
Yeah, because each time he casts, he's going to destroy a boulder. He will cast three times, so you must move behind three different boulders. After the second time, he's going to change position to try to screw you over on the boulder.
Which one is it, damn it? Is that it? No, isn't it?
I got the gem cutter.
Bro, I really want to do what you teach me so bad. You see, I stand in the middle, and I just kind of stare at the different actions, and I'm like, I don't know what it looks like, and I'll hit something random.
Damn. Sadly...
I'm trying. I want to do it.
At least the bard's trying to hide. It's a little slow on the uptake on the first one, but...
He did it. He got it.
No, it's still targeting. He's trying to hide in the boulder instead of behind the boulder. Yeah, there he goes. Until the tether actually locks onto the boulder and not you, you're in the wrong spot.
So how's been? How's Texas been?
Say again.
How's home being back home been? You know, how's it been? You know, getting to see the missus.
Yeah. I'm just ready to go back to Ohio, honestly. I mean, Texas is fine, but I'm just ready to be back in Cleveland.
How about them boys, man? Us Giants, we had to handle our business. The Giants had to handle our business.
I still can't believe they fucking lost to Buffalo twice, but goddamn it.
Yeah,
even
buddy.
A blind squirrel gets a nut occasionally.
Oh, man. Yeah, I haven't been able to catch too many of the games, but, you know, the recent moving around a bunch, but I try to catch a few games when I can.
They need to be killing the wind-up Magus.
Alright, so let me see if I can get a closer picture of those. Which are the blue ones or the red ones?
The blue ones.
Alright, so they should be killing the blue ones. And why do we have to kill the blue ones?
Because they're the ones that do the AOE meteor.
Okay, that's that circular.
It makes them pain in the ass for,
the
yeah,
circular
that
attack.
I'm constantly having to dodge.
Yeah. Okay, I mean, when those big circular bads, those things are cast by the blue little mage things.
Now, the centaurs do have an AOE and they're very large, but they don't cast as consistently as the Magus does. And most of the time, the centaurs will cast their AOE at the same time, so you just stun one and run away from the other. Going all the way down.
Sounds good, broski. Let's do it. Oh, my bad. I caught that a little bit too late.
What the hell? Come on, I'm trying to put him in place here, people. Y'all are killing me. What the fuck? How did my grip get turned off?
I hit that. I'll misclick sometimes. I mean, I know you're professional, but it happens to the best of us.
I'm trying to figure out how the fuck my grip got turned off. That's not bueno.
Yeah, man, no bueno. I'd be using that too. I'm like, that was no... I'm like, if you guys get hit by this, that is no bueno.
Ow. Damn it.
You gotta blow up your own spot, bro. You know, I would never say anything bad about you.
I'm still.
I didn't even notice. I wasn't looking at any of that.
Oh, I was.
I'm trying to cast my holy.
There. No, I just wasn't paying attention. Honestly.
Oh, I put that in the wrong spot. Oh, I forgot to come out of cleric. Noob. I guess I could always hit this button. I know you told me that, because Jay over here, he's also an amazing white mage. most amazing. So he tells me, you know, he gives me pointers because I just like to dabble in the white magic a little bit, you know, to keep my friends from going to zero health.
Yeah. But well, let's see. I only main that class for the entire first part, the entire fucking AR or.
You know, I still have session. You're gonna be in a bunch of my AAR videos too, because I still have to do those, buddy. But that's for the next year. Oh yeah, that's coming, man. I'm not gonna forget about that. I just had to handle some stuff. You get to kill these cool dolls. Aren't they freaky?
Bad stuff.
These freaky dolls.
Okay, first, this boss is pretty simple too. Don't stack on the fucking tank. Don't stack behind the tank. And everything will be great. If you get glare cast on you, run away from the party and face away from the boss. When or if you get turned into a doll, or if you don't, kill the person who was turned into a doll so they can revert back to their former form.
When Jason explains,
red mark equals glare.
When he does it to me, he's normally as detailed as possible.
And how the hell? See, that's something that's kind of weird. I've got full aggro on this boss. Yet, attack the front. If the shields come up, you must attack the boss from the front, or all damage will be reflected. As you can tell by the two DPS that are taking mass damage, they do not know what they're
doing.
These
crazy mofos.
And now they're getting turned into dolls. Kill the dolls as quickly as possible. Because as long as the dolls are up, she's going to keep slapping the floor and doing that AoE.
I thought I killed her.
You did.
I'm like, why is she still a doll, man?
Tank buster? Or at least what they consider a tank buster.
She cast the petrification. If you get the eye over your head, you want to not face the boss.
To face away. As the bard did not face away, she is now confused and attacking random party members.
That's always fun when your best friend's kicking your ass right now.
Brace, attack from the front.
No! I'm a freaky doll. Watch me dance. Me and Jason were amazing dancers. Check us out. I'm this cool blue one. Oh, look at those crazy lasers we shoot.
I'll give it up. At least they got the healer out first. That's good sign.
Hey, nobody got caught, bro.
Yeah, they have the ability to learn. They can be taught. Brace, attack from the front.
But this is typically how I would tank it as well. I would have her facing, like, the outside of arena. It's easier to control. Alright, so everyone, thank you for watching my video. You know what to do if you like it. You just gotta hit that button on the bottom. I hope you enjoyed the commentary by myself and not only me. Because I'm always gonna be here. It's my stuff. But my friend Jay, Mr. Snake over here. Looking all sexy. Hold on, Jay. Let's do a shot together. Actually, you know what? I like to dance. I always do a dance. So let's do a dance. Pick whatever dance you got. Just random dance. Yeah, man, we gotta dance. Oh wait, let me calm the person. This is, I don't wanna. I'm surprised they didn't
I calm the dragoon, so calm the bard, and I'll be right with the world.
World up. So hold on. So now let me pick one. Let me stand over. I love the gold dance. You know what? I'd be rocking that. I gotta find it first. I can't see anything. These words are so small.
I'm gonna have crap to buy at the fucking gold saucer. I've got like 790,000 fucking MGP I can't use.
How much?
791,265.
Yo, Jay's got mad MGP. But that's it, guys. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed the guide. And we out. Peace.